ओके ओके,
चंद्र लेकर गुड इवनिंग। हेलो लिली,
शी इज जस्ट जॉइनिंग आई थिंक, शी स्टिल ऑन म्यूट।
ओके,
गुड इवनिंग।
सर वाज आस्किंग फॉर फेसबुक लिंक इफ यू कैन। गुड इवनिंग।
गुड इवनिंग।
या गुड इवनिंग लिली मैम।
गुड इवनिंग।
Good evening, good evening, ma'am. Good evening.
You can, if you can send the Facebook link to me.
Sir, sending it 2 minutes, sir.
Okay, okay. No issues, no issues. Renuka, ma'am, good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. How are you?
Fine.
Fine, thank you.
So, I have forgotten what we have to talk. After seeing so many.
That will remember when we are talking.
Yes, जैसे exam लिखते लिखते याद आता है ना what answer we have to write for this question.
कुछ पढ़ के आए तब ना.
नहीं पढ़ने की क्या जरूरत है, your experience will speak for you. We are experienced now, we don't need to read and study.
Yeah, नहीं पढ़ने वाले blank हो जाते हैं, जो नहीं पढ़ के
आए तो चलता है. बिंदास.
Correct.
Okay, Bhavna ma'am is also joined.
Okay.
I will share my screen for some time for 3-4 slides and
yes,
for
yes,
one
sir.
Video.
Yeah. Yes, sir. So, shall we?
Bhavna ma'am, good evening.
She's getting ready, I think.
Hmm. Yeah.
Jyoti ma'am is always ready.
Arre wa.
Ready reckoner personality.
क्यों?
Good evening भावना मैम.
और कोई नहीं मिला शाम को.
भावना मैम, you're on mute. You're on mute. Please unmute yourself.
मैं अभी CBSE का वेबिनार करके आई हूँ.
हाँ.
आप भी? Just now.
Good, good.
Good evening Mr. Prasad.
Good evening भावना मैम. Good evening.
Good evening
भावना मैम.
Well, evening भावना.
It's a pleasure to meet you all here on this platform.
Jyotsna Thomas is not smiling. Yeah, adu seriya. Chirichille.
Since we are already.
Humko samajh mein aa gaya aapne kya bola Jyoti ma'am.
Good. It's but natural, you know. Reshmi is also looking very serious. Sir, aapne mana kar diya unko smile karne ke liye.
Kisko? Nahi nahi.
And I will introduce everybody. So we start with a small introduction of the host, the P2 International. Okay, we are an ISO certified organization and member of Pan Global Mental Arithmetic Association, with a rich experience of 16 years, presence in Mumbai, Pune, Nasik, Bangalore. Managing more than 75 plus centers, 100 plus trainers, and 8,500 plus students. We are working with prestigious schools like Jamnabai Nursi, ISKCON, Janki Devi, Datta Mege World Academy, Pawar Public School, Sayadri International Pune, Saraswati Vidyalay, and GSPM Pune, and many more. We work on the hand-mind coordination, visual skills, auditory skills, critical thinking, problem solving, analytical thinking, quantitative reasoning, time management, and improving the mental math skills of children from the age group of 5 to 14 years with the help of Abacus, and tricks to mathematics through Vedic techniques. We have been encouraging and motivating children to face the competitive world by organizing large-scale competitions at the zonal, state, national, and international level for mental maths. This video is showing you all that we've been speaking about. We also conduct competitions called as an auditory skill. Okay, you will not be able to hear what's happening, but this is basically numbers are being dictated to the students, and they are imagining the abacus in front of them and calculating. So basically not using any calculators, calculating fast and giving out the answers. So this is what we work on, the auditory skills also. We conduct the national level competition at a large scale. We have more than 1,500, 2,000 students appearing at one single day, on one single day, where the competition starts right from the morning and goes on through the evening. We declare the results on the same day, felicitate everybody on the same day, and try to see the children achieve something at the end of the day. Our children facing international competitions and coming out as winners. And this is our team of teachers, our trainers who have been with us and who are supporting us all this time. We have with us Preeti Pasricha. She's been working as an assistant primary coordinator in CP Goenka International School, Thane. She's an MCOM B.Ed, a diploma in early childhood, pursuing a post-graduation diploma in school leadership and management. She's done a post-graduation diploma in psychotherapy and counseling, and a diploma in HR from Wellingkar Institute. During her journey in the last 18 years in education, she has demonstrated her commitment ensuring that students have access to a vibrant educational provision. As a primary coordinator, she has played a pivotal role in the establishment of shared goals across the schools involved in her journey. She also has led a number of initiatives for teachers, training, and programs that will benefit child's learning. She does not hesitate to adapt and innovate. Her highly developed technology skills are future focused and allow her to experiment and think laterally. Her enthusiasm and collaborative approach has encouraged and strengthened parents' participation in their children's education. Welcome on board, Preeti.
Thank you for the wonderful introduction. It's actually my pleasure working all these years with P-Square. Entirely my pleasure. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you. And our panelists for the day, we have Mr. Pramod Mahajan, who is a principal school director of Sarja Indian School. He's a core member of Community Volunteers Team, Education Wing, Office of Council General CGI India, Dubai, UAE. A core member of Working Group of Education Wing of the Office of Ambassador, the Embassy of India, Abu Dhabi. He's one of the Board of Directors of Principals Council of Sarja Private Education Authority, Government of Sarja. A core member and secretary of the Principal's Executive Council of Sarja Private Education Authority, Government of Sarja. His CBSE assignments, examination assignments are, he's been a district coordinator for NVST 5 times, a center superintendent for AISSCE 25 times, moderator of AISSCE Physics 10 times, a GIIT prelims and 5 times, NTA City Observer for GIIT 3 times. The scientific achievements, the national level, a first prize winner in Intel Science Talent Discovery Fair awarded by Director Nehru Science Center, organized by Intel Asia Electronics Limited USA and Nehru Science Center, awarded by Edumatic New Delhi for the project of learning through computers. His international achievements are participated in the Global School Leaders Conference conducted by University of Queensland, Australia on futuristic leadership, school assessment, professional development, and cross-cultural exchange in the global context as speaker and key delegate, awarded by NASA, the USA for scientific educational excursion, participated in the World Education Summit, Dubai, conducted digital learning magazine in association with KHDA as keynote speaker on outcome-based education, importance of technological interventions by University of Helsinki in November 17. Participated in the World School Leaders Conference conducted by University of Helsinki, Finland on school leadership and global trends in education in October 2017. Merit certificate holder of Intel International Science and Engineering Fair awarded by Director General, National Council of Science Museum. International School Award 2014-17 by British Council. Recognized and awarded by British Council for leading the integration of international learning. Awarded with Education Excellence Award for Excellence in Professional Development by IndieWood, Government of Telangana, Make in India and Council of International Media. Awarded with the citation Fabulous Global Educational Leader during the 8th edition of World Education Congress at Taj Lands, Mumbai. Recognized as the keynote speaker on education for a sustainable future. Has been invited as one of the global EDU leaders, only one from UAE, to attend the World Education Leadership Symposium held at the University of Zurich, Department of Teacher Education, Government of Switzerland. Has been awarded the Entrepreneur of the Year at House of Commons and British Parliament in the presence of Global Life Coach Sri Guru Gopal Das and Ms. Seema Mandotra, Member of Parliament for Feltham and Heston, UK. Director, he has been awarded by Director NBS New Delhi for creative work on Project Vidya, Educom Datamatics New Delhi for creative works on IT-based advanced teachings, teach techniques, NCERT New Delhi for paper presentation on planning and teaching tactics in national seminar on IT and schooling process in India, merit performance for IT-based lesson plans on heat engine and nuclear fission awarded by Intel Asia Electronics Limited USA. He has received the National Educational Award for Educational Excellence in Mumbai, awarded by Times of India Group as speaker during their Principals Conclave 2019 at Sahara Star, Mumbai, awarded by Next Education as keynote speaker during the 3 days residential international conference on EdTech for the 21st century school at Park Hyatt, Hyderabad, and awarded rank one school in Sharjah Emirates by Education World Global School Ranking Awards 2019. Welcome on board.
Thank you.
Both Mahajan, very, very inspiring.
Thank you.
Very, very motivating. And sir, hum to kahi bhi nahi aapke samne, sir. It's like, how do you get
it's the not time? Like that.
But aap kya, sir, how do you get the time to do all this?
Keep on doing something.
Fantastic, sir. Fantastic. Great, great, sir. Welcome, sir. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you. So kind of
you. Really great to have you on our panel, sir.
Same here. Same here.
We have our next panelist, Jyoti Ramachandran. She is an accomplished school pedagogical leader of national repute and authorized teacher educator for CBSE and NCERT, part of their book writing teams also. She's an author and an academic writer. She moonlights as a storyteller too, especially for STEM, and is a winner of several awards in educational leadership. She volunteers with rural children of Tamil Nadu, Andhra, and Rajasthan on a regular basis. The philosophy in life is Zindagi Nahi Milegi Dubara. Enjoy. Wow, Jyoti ma'am.
Great. Great. Great.
Most welcome. Good to have you with us, ma'am. We have our next panelist, Bhavna Dagli. She's a passionate educator with a demonstrated history of working in the education industry for more than 25 years. Highly skilled in administration and management of education, teacher training, and skill building, student counseling, and action research. A qualified professional with a strong belief in ethical school leadership. Currently holding the position of principal at Bibjor Roots and Rise Kalyan. Welcome, Bhavna ma'am. And thank you for accepting our invite and being a panelist with us. And our next panelist, Lily Roy, has worked in the education field for over 26 years and is known to have made a difference in the lives of the children who are under her as a teacher as well as a principal. She is proficient in curriculum development, teacher training, and team building. She has leadership experience in ICSE, CBSE, as well as Maharashtra State Board Schools, and is currently working as a founder principal of a renowned CBSE school in Pune. A motivational speaker and an influencer who firmly believes that students are the future of the country and the teachers are responsible for making the future brighter. Hence, she highly promotes 21st century skills development early in children and encourages the teachers to lead with emotional intelligence to improve student engagement. She firmly believes in inculcating moral values in education. She has written various articles for Hindustan Times and the Hindi newspaper Navbharat. She has received the Best District Principal Award from Science Olympiad Foundation. Welcome, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. It's my pleasure.
And it's wonderful to have all four of you with us. Thank you very much. Thank you for being with us. Great. So we now start for our much awaited discussion. One of the hottest buzzwords in business and industry, artificial intelligence. AI technology is a crucial linchpin of much of the digital transformation taking place today as organizations position themselves to capitalize on the ever-growing amount of data being generated and collected. So with this thing in mind, Bhavna ma'am, can I put my first question to you, ma'am? Bhavna ma'am?
Ma'am, unmute yourself.
Can you please unmute?
Am I audible now?
Yes, ma'am, you are. Yes.
Yes, Dr. Prasad. Dr. Prasad, yes, what you have said is very apt in the current scenario. I would go by what you say, because if we look at the artificial intelligence, the term, it very rightly says that it's simulating the human mind, a machine which will be able to simulate human mind. Going by that, if we look at the human mind, it has ability to think, to create, to analyze, and to come to certain conclusions. So if we have to look at artificial intelligence and consider it as the linchpin of all the current development in science and technology, definitely we'll have to go by the fact that the machine that we create should be very much like the human brain. It should be something like a blueprint of the human brain, which will be able to think and create new things, as you have said, rightly said. And if we look at the developments that have happened in the AI, definitely it is able to bring in to a great extent the greed that human beings have had collecting huge amount of data. And that collected data needs to be analyzed, and we need to come up with new ideas. Keeping in mind the pace at which the world is growing, I think artificial intelligence is the buzzword, and the way we have developed, right from whether it's the household chores that the ladies do on a daily basis, or it is the healthcare industry, or we take the education industry, each and every part of the world, every action that we make definitely is going to be impacted in one way or the other by artificial intelligence. So we cannot rule out how it has taken over the current scene. And of course, the developments that are happening in the future, whether we talk about the Google Assistant or we talk about the Siri, how it is helping us, or you say, if we talk about Watson, the platform which is able to help us come out with the new ideas and the scientific development, I think that's what you have said is absolutely right.
Very true, Bhavna ma'am. And yes, absolutely, artificial intelligence is the buzzword now. And I believe it's there everywhere. As you said, in the hospital, in the education industry, it is there.
Absolutely.
And it is the buzzword. It is the next thing.
If at all we have to talk about, say, the customer care service, we talk about the legal system, or we talk about, say, the financial institutes, each and every part, wherever we think of, or we try to put our finger on, we cannot think of a world which will not be involving artificial intelligence. Or whether you say, for a simple example, like your household work, you can have bots at home who can take over the work that the women are doing on a daily basis, right from mopping the house to cooking, or it can be just taking over all the other household work. I mean, it is absolutely the buzzword. Or we take the healthcare industry, or say it goes to right from analyzing the genomic data and coming up with various conclusions on what will be the next course of action, whether it is in the medical field or the surgeries, or it can be, or say, amputation and artificial replacement of limbs, etc. Everywhere, we cannot think of a world without artificial.
Absolutely true, ma'am. Thank you. Ma'am, I'll come back to you. Surely come back to you. But with this, I would like to ask Jyoti, ma'am. Ma'am, can artificial intelligence help fill gaps in learning and teaching and allow schools and teachers to do more than ever before? What do you think on this, ma'am?
Good evening, everyone. All of you, nice, beautiful minds that you are. And I would like to share one thing about Pramod Mahajan. I just told him there is a nice organization, they want you to speak. He said yes, immediately. He didn't ask me anything else. So I want to thank him formally on records that without a word, that is the humility of a great person.
Aapka aadesh sir aankhon par aur kuch nahi.
Ab batting ulta maar diya. Self goal kar diya.
So this,
I'm sharing this with all his team, because the team knows him this way as well as the other way, but outsiders see him from a different point of view. And I formally thank Pramod for being here without any kind of airs. It's wonderful to have such principles. Thank you again. Okay, coming back, you know, I spoke all this because I am scared to answer the other big real questions. I'm also like a child trying to divert the attention of the teacher. So, Prasad asked me whether it can fill up the gaps or not. I'm sure it has helped us to fill all the gaps that we are right now facing. In fact, I have done this maybe about 5 years before. I have started online teaching for graduates and postgraduates with Karnataka State Open University. And we were able to fill the gaps that you speak about. And now all of a sudden, with the pandemic, we are doing something very different. You would have not believed that you would be as famous as anybody else. Say, even in the month of Jan, I don't think we would have believed that. So teachers, we have become very famous. We have become international players. And coming back to the gap in learning, I think it is helping us, the student, to have a self-paced learning at one point of time. It is helping the teacher.
I'm sorry.
Can we request all of us to go on mute? All the participants to be on mute. Thank you. Jyoti ma'am, you can continue.
So I feel this has really helped the teachers, the parents also, because many times they did not know what was happening in the school. That there is another set of parents who are really ready to pounce on us, that's a different issue. That is professional or occupational hazard. And then we find that the same thing need not be repeated again and again. So the gaps which were there, they are being filled up. And also what is happening is there was a gap in our learning also. We had finished, we had M.Ed, M.Phil, everything. Then we had come to a stage, everyone, those who are complete, we feel we had learned everything. Suddenly, we found that we didn't know anything at all. Right. You were as new or in your learning as your student of even KG. because the student will tell you, Miss, unmute yourself. Miss, mute yourself. So that, you know, these were the gaps which were there. And I think it has proved to be a boon for all of us. And repetitive tasks, boring tasks, difficult tasks. Like you cannot stop the teacher for a second and say, Miss, I don't understand, wait. But you can stop a recording, then listen, then go back. So I think it has played a very good tool to, you know, help the students to get more equipped. But yes, without a teacher, nothing works. So this intelligence has to be with us always. I hope you are fine with the answer.
Perfectly, ma'am. Perfectly right. Perfectly fine. Thank you. Thank you so much. And I will surely get back to you too, ma'am. But before that, we have something for Pramod, sir.
Yeah, we are waiting to hear him.
Yes, all of us. And sir, since the students of today to work in a future where artificial intelligence is actually a reality, is it important that our educational institutions expose students to use the technology?
Yeah. So let us think about the fundamental things first. Okay. Like artificial intelligence, it is a buzzing word, and actually it is buzzing. But by name itself, it is clear it is artificial. The originality lies with the teacher. The originality lies with the human trends. The originality lies with the autonomy which we used to give to the student. Now, there are two aspects. Whether we are using technology or whether we are learning technology. If we are using technology, definitely it is very, very needed, useful, and it will give the, it will ensure the learning outcomes. But if we are learning about the technology, so the thing is now, it is an exponential change. Every moment, things are changing. So like if you take the case of engineering, whatever they learn in first year, by the way, they reach to third year or fourth year, that technology is outdated. So if you are learning technology, it's good for nothing. Yes, but if you are utilizing technology, you are teaching using technology, that is important. And then how to teach and how to use that technology, it all depends to the exposure. Now, exposure is what and how the learning happens. Let me share my screen and then I'll come to those points. If you allow me to share the screen.
Yes, sir, you can. You can.
Yeah. Is it visible? Is the screen visible?
Yes, it is. Yes, it is.
So whether we are using technology or we are learning technology, it all depends. If we are using technology, it is in true sense intelligence. But if you are learning only technology, it will remain artificial only. What I mean to say, don't limit a child to your own learning, for he was born in another time, Rabindranath Tagore. Long, long ago, that futuristic person has identified that thing. We should not limit the learning process of our children. Now, if we are not limiting the learning process of a child, we have to understand that how the learning happens. So Professor Sugata Mitra, he has done one experiment, hole in a wall, and it proved that learning happened naturally. It's by nature learning happens. Learning happens in a better way when there is a minimum intervention. So minimum intervention means what? No one can replace the classroom teaching. No one can replace the teacher. But it's a time when academic bossing will not work. It's a time when teacher-driven classes will not give you any output. And there is a role of exposure of technology in the education field. Now, what's that? Do not educate your child in the way you are educated. The way we are educated, if you are trying to educate the child in that manner, then the things will go wrong. Learning happens naturally and with minimum intervention. So you need not to intervene, you need not to disturb their learning process because it is happening naturally. Then how to teach them? So teacher must go along with the learner as a scaffolder. Wherever the child is going, let the student go with his or her pace and speed. And the teacher should act as a scaffolder. The capacity of a child to reach here, child is at a down level. How to go that? Give the variety of path and the things will happen. For that, what are the requirements? Curriculum. Now, curriculum should be technology based. Here, the exposure of technology is must. Pedagogy. Your traditional pedagogy will not work. Now, the pedagogy is in such a manner that you are teaching through the machine, not you are learning the machine. Assessment. Do the assessment by using machine. Do that assessment by using technology. Do the assessment by using the process. And in that way, what to assess? What to assess? That is a question mark. It's a big question mark. If you are assessing the child to find out his or her fault, things will not work because that is the way you were taught. And now those days were gone. So what we have to assess, you have to challenge the child and then you have to answer those questions or you have to frame those questions which are yet to be asked. You have to discuss about those technology which are yet to be invented. I would like to cite one example that this Mangalyaan, Mars, when they were designing, the challenge was finance. The Prime Minister of India has given them the verdict that we don't have that much money, we have this much money only. So what those scientists have done, they have done small science exhibition from the rural areas to the hi-fi cities, theoretical aspects. And they got the inputs from those science exhibition that yes, it is possible. That is called the assessment. That is the assessment. And by that, they are able to make the Mangalyaan, which is as reasonable as the auto rickshaw. See the role of assessment, but that assessment happened by using technology, giving exposure by technology. Now, they say, what is assessment and what is examination? Now, if you take the case of a doctor, you go to the doctor, that is, being I am a person of biophysics, I'll take that example. You go to the doctor, he will take your temperature, he will pulse, whatever be. So that is all examination. Outcome is nothing. You're taking your temperature, finding out the pulse, measuring your BP, whatever. These are all examination which we are doing nowadays. Assessment is what? On the basis of that, the doctor will say, it may be a viral. It will not be a corona at all. The symptoms are like that, but it is definitely a viral. So let us treat for the virus. Not for the corona. Let us treat the fever as a viral fever. That is called assessment. So that assessment is possible using the technology and giving the exposure to the technology, not by the machine. Machine is measuring the temperature. Forget nothing. That is artificial intelligence. What is the original thing is how that temperature is varying. What is the surface area of the body? What is the height of that person? What is the weight of that person? Then surface area. Then if the temperature rises in that manner, it means it will not be a corona, it will not be a flu, it will be a viral fever. That is called assessment. And in that manner, if we implement, things will happen. Technology is important, but technology is not everything. Future is in technology, no doubt, but yet the bigger future lies in transcending it. How you are utilizing the technology, that is the bigger future. Everything is technologically wired now, which is useless, which is dumped, is now wired intellectually. And that is called artificial intelligence. I'm a man of electronics. I am in it. The basic branch is electronics. This IT and information technologies are all the hybridized branches. So we are not thinking about the originality. And you are rightly said it's a buzzing word. It's buzzing only. Thing is, now performance is reached to perfection. science fiction becomes science facts. Quantum computing is changing the world. Technology is all how to change, but the human trends, why to change? And for that, why to change? Exposure to the technology is important. The future just not happened, but it gets happened. Now the question arises whether you are driven by change or you are making a change. That's the main question. So what I mean to say, exposure to the technology is must, but the human trends, creativity, critical thinking, innovation, imagination, ethics, that is more important. And the future will be for that. Let me clear my point by a video, which is very close to my heart. Digital transformation is the future, but a bigger future is in human trends. What's that video says, please concern, focus on that. And then again, we'll discuss in the second round how the technology can be used only, not misused. Learning about technology is misuse of technology. They are telling we are using the PowerPoint presentation and we are showing videos. That is misuse of technology. Play with the technology. That is the exposure of technology. Let's see the video and then we'll continue. Is it audible? Sound?
Once upon a time, business as usual was often good enough. No more. Where we are going, good enough is dead.
Good enough is dead.
In a world where everything is connected, where everything is equally excellent, where performance is reaching perfection, there's only one space left to innovate in. You.
You. That is
right
feature.
Now, you that are a central student. Point in that the raging tornado of change fueled by digitization, mobilization, augmentation, disintermediation, automation. Well, the list goes on. Science fiction is becoming science fact. Think about self-driving cars or computers that can learn and think. The way we work will never be the same. The skills we need will be dramatically different. Winning or losing are now happening faster than ever before.
No win,
so what's your response? How will you discover new opportunities in one of the most transformational times in human history? Are you driving change or are you being driven by it?
You have to drive.
Disruption has become the new normal. With change, it's always gradually, then suddenly, well, things really have stopped happening gradually. This change is exponential.
Exponential change.
Everything that used to be dumb and disconnected is now wired and intelligent. Cars, cities, ports, farms, even our bodies will be wired with sensors and will talk to each other. These game changers are also combinatorial. They amplify each other, creating a perfect storm of change. Quantum computing fuels big data. The Internet of Things fuels artificial intelligence and deep learning, which fuels robotics. However, anything that cannot be digitized or automated will become extremely valuable.
That is the future.
Human-only traits such as creativity, imagination, intuition, emotion, and ethics will be even more important in the future because machines are very good at simulating but not at being. Yes, robots and software will do some of our work, but this will allow us to focus on things that cannot be automated. To imagine change squared, you've got to start engaging more with what might be, not just with what is. Immerse yourself in the immediate future, 5 to 7 years out from today. We need to go beyond technology and data
beyond
to reach human insights
only,
and wisdom. Technology represents the how of change, but humans represent the why. The future is about holistic business models. The opportunity is to be liquid, to learn just in time, not just in case, not single improvements, but complete transformations, not individual systems, but new ecosystems. Humanity is where true and lasting value is created. We will engage, relate, and buy things because of the experiences they provide, because of their transformative power. The future doesn't just happen. the future gets happened. The new way to work is to embrace technology, but not to become it. The future is in technology, yet the bigger future lies in transcending it.
Bigger future lies in utilizing the technology, giving the exposure to the technology, but not becoming a technology, not becoming a machine, and not working with the machine, but use the machine for working. So for that purpose, the new trend, the global trends are must, and that will be achieved by creativity, innovation, imagination. All those things are must, and that will be given only by the teacher, but not by the traditional teacher. Now they are saying technology is a threat to the teachers. Not at all. The technologically illiterate teachers are the threat to themselves. If they are technologically sound, future will be there. And for that soundness, exposure of technology to the teaching learning process, to the teacher, to the students and the schools is must. So that's my input on that.
Great, great, sir. Thank you so much. Very, very detailed explanation. Fantastic, sir. Super. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. We will really want to hear you again with the next question. But before that, we have our next panelist, Lily Roy.
Good evening.
Good evening. Ma'am, my question to you is, can artificial intelligence help make global classrooms available to all, including those who speak different languages or who might have visual or learning impairments, hearing impairments?
Yes, sir. Thank you for the question. Yes, definitely. It's, there are some translators are there, and we have seen in the YouTubes and all, maybe a teacher is teaching in Japanese and he can understand Hindi or English or any other language. So it can translate into their own choice of the language. So what is this? This is artificial intelligence. So yes, globally it can change. So our students, at USA or somewhere, their professor is teaching in their language, and at India, a student wants to know about the subject. So it can translate. So, okay, it's globally, it can be done. Same way for visually impaired children also, that can be, they can listen to their, they cannot see. So they can listen according to their own choice of the language. Same way the child who has a, hearing impairments, they can see the language, the comfortable language, whatever they are comfortable, they will choose and they can see. So yes, obviously it can be globally, it can, artificial intelligence can change globally and all will be. So we have seen in YouTube, you can see there's all things are happening. We can go for any YouTube. If you go to YouTube, and we can see according to our whatever comfortable language. So this all are, this is because of the translator. And what is that? That is machine learning. And who is doing this? Because of artificial intelligence, it is going on. Since we are doing that, sir.
Very true. Very true, Lily, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you very much. And we have really got wonderful answers from everybody. Very convincing. And my next question, Jyoti ma'am. Jyoti ma'am, the next question to you.
Yeah.
Can artificial intelligence drive efficiency, personalization, and streamline admin tasks to allow teachers the time and freedom to provide understanding and adaptability? What do you think on this, ma'am?
Every time I get the longest question. Okay, so anyway, that's fun. Once again, I appreciate Pramod's wonderful explanation. I wish he was my physics teacher. so methodical, so well put, well prepared, and I would I really appreciate. Now coming back to the things that we have been discussing, artificial intelligence, yes, is really helpful in the sense the mundane tasks can definitely be handed over to a computer. Pramod sir is all shaking his head, which is true. We don't have to trouble the teachers for very mundane things like attendance and so many other things. So I think that is happening. Two, now teachers will have their own opinion because they feel the principals are this side and they are on that side. But I'm sure teachers that it has brought in some kind of more time for you to do more research. You might say, no, we have been told by the principal to do this, we have to do that. That is because we were learning new things. Like he was saying, your principal, we were adapting to new technology. So that was the time it was an issue. But otherwise, I think today, you don't have to repeat the same thing what you have done, say, 3 weeks before. You can continuously show things. Admin is being taken care, and I'm sure in your school you have a good LMS, robust LMS system, which must be helping you to do mundane things. Otherwise, you don't know where to store your video, you don't know where to store your audio, then whether it should be Google Classroom, whether it is Microsoft Teams, you know, that problem, I'm sure you don't have it. So again, there what happens? It is artificial intelligence which is happening. Otherwise, 30 years, even last year, we didn't have this kind of a sturdy, robust systems of LMS. Like Lily was speaking about translator. I'm learning a language which is very easy, Chinese, Mandarin. So I find that AI is being used everywhere. Like to understand a word, I go back to Google Translate or Pleco. Especially the written part is very, very easy. Mandarin, it's the most difficult language, by the way. So to go through the strokes this way, that way, no teacher will have the patience to help us out. No teacher will say, okay, sit next to me, I will do that. So definitely I feel AI is one aspect which is going to be part of it. Also, personally, I would say in a few minutes from now, I have a teleconference with my dentist because my tooth is aching. I requested Prasad, let me jump the gun. So that is happening because I can technologically meet him. He's going to give me some medicine. And also, I'm a little while ago, I was discussing with Preeti and Prasad that I believe in a lot of our myths, traditional stories. All this had happened even with Sanjay and Dhritarashtra. Dhritarashtra asked, what is happening on the field? Sanjay tells him. So for me, I think it is artificial intelligence. That is, something is making him see Doordrishti. It might be a total wrong takeoff, huh? But this is my way of thinking. Then Abhimanyu, how did he learn? Through maybe some sonar waves, sonic waves, and maybe some different artificial intelligence must have helped him to understand that, right? So this is all a different takeoff than Pushpak Viman, Ravan. That also must have been made. I'm so happy Rajeshri Rajama smiling at my reference. So all this, something superior must have been there. Some intelligence, whether you call it artificial or whether it is human or some other one, alien, but definitely it was there very, very, and it is getting reflected now. If you have seen a movie called Robo Kid, now teachers, please go and see that movie. That is fully, fully AI. I'm very fond of watching such movies. So that is purely AI, and it speaks about some nuclear warfare by which US decides to stop. So I think at a personal level, AI is very useful. Otherwise, you want a song, you tell Alexa, get me that song. How does that magic happen? Right. And when you, I like to tease Alexa, I love you. I don't love you. I say it differently. It says, sorry, I don't understand. So the limitation is there. So I think we are far more superior. We, just as Pramod sir was saying, let us use technology to our benefit. I think I have answered. Full marks milega, all the principles.
Bilkul.
Thank you. I'm having a plan.
Wonderful, wonderful insights, wonderful insights.
I'll catch up again. I'll finish my call and come back.
Sure, ma'am.
इतना आसानी से छोड़ूंगी नहीं.
नहीं नहीं बिल्कुल हम लोग भी नहीं छोड़ेंगे मैम.
Welcome back.
Oh, great. It's really going very great. And Bhavna ma'am, now this is for you. How is AI used in education, ma'am? According to you, how is AI used in education?
To this, Dr. Prasad and the viewers, I would say that AI is playing a very crucial role. It has been playing since some time, and of course, in the coming times as well. It's going to take over a lot of responsibilities of the teacher. I would not say the entire thing, as Dr. Prasad has rightly put, that we cannot be the ones who will be making technology, but if we are using, yes, education is one of the important sectors where AI is used in complete sync with what is the need of the hour. If we look at right from the MS Teams that we are using or the various digital platforms we are using currently, to whether it will come to the, say, just-in-time assessments, that on the spot, if we want to test our children and understand as to what has been their understanding, to what level we were able to impart education, or to what level we could build their confidence, I think AI is going very well in that. And of course, in the future as well, with the improvement in the technology. Besides that, if we look at, say, for example, children who are having learning disabilities, especially children having autism, they have problems with social interaction. So I think AI can play a very crucial role by helping them, being their companions in a way, and help them hone on their social skills furthermore as to from where they are and how we can help them socialize and develop the various other skills where they are lacking. Or we look at kids who are having certain physical problems, like say they have gone through a surgery or they are having some constraints in being with the children, like allergies or any contagious disease for time being they are into. I think AI would be playing a great role by getting the teacher at home. We'll be having teachers with them at home. If they are not able to read school, the school will be at their place. Like it's going to be to that extent. Besides that, if we look at, say, for example, the various types of diagnostic testing, if we look at children who are suffering from various learning disabilities, how can we help them better in understanding as to what is the exact type of help, that intervention at what level, the teacher's role, or whether the school's intervention, or the counselor, or the therapy, or it can be anything else, medication. I think AI would be the most sought after, I would say, the word which we all will be looking at. And besides that, if we say we want some assistance when the teacher is not there, there is something that you want to recall in the absence of the teacher, I think AI would be playing a wonderful role. Whether you want a reader, a robo reader with you, or you want somebody to help you understand some certain scientific experiment that was conducted in the class, I think AI would be playing a great role by bringing in these assistance with the children.
Absolutely.
Education cannot be taught without AI, neither now nor in the future.
Very true, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am, for your inputs. Lily, ma'am, my question to you now is, an educator spends a tremendous amount of time grading homework and tests. So can AI step in and make quick workouts of these tasks? What do you think, ma'am?
Yes, thanks for the question. Definitely, sir. As it is, now multiple choice question, it's AI, through AI only, it's get it done. All this competitive exam like Science Olympiad or in JEE, NEET, all the competitive exams, so this one word question answer or multiple choice, it is going on. It's working on. And in future also the assessment, long type answers or, you know, more than 1,000 words or 100 words, it will be obviously work is going on. And yes, if it is done, then teachers can focus their time for planning their lesson, or they can focus their time to how to teach better way, or individual attention they can pay towards the students rather, you know, checking the notebooks or the answer sheets. I remember as a maths teacher, I was a maths teacher. So I used to carry all the notebooks or all the, you know, answer sheet, and it used to take a long time. So nowadays, just see with Google Forms, teachers multiple choice questions, they are, you know, on the spot answer, means they are getting the marks. So it's because of this AI, because of this, you know, technology, it is helping. And one more thing, what will happen if AI will help in checking long type answers and all. What will happen sometimes, you know, when teachers are checking the answers and looking at the same type of answer, sometimes, not always, biased teachers get biased or somewhere. But due to this AI, this will not happen. So it will be checked in the sense thoroughly. I'm not meaning that teachers are not checking the notebooks or test paper properly. But yes, obviously, if this work will be done by AI, so teachers' workload will be less so that they can focus on their lesson planning, or individual attention towards the students will be given more. So obviously, it will be, teachers' workload will be less if this AI will come. Thank
you. Great, man. Absolutely true. Thank you. Thank you so much, man.
Thank you, sir.
And Pramod sir, back to you now. And we would like to hear this from you. Will artificial intelligence allow a level of differentiation that's impossible for teachers who have to manage 30 students in each class? What is your take on this, sir?
Yeah. First of all, it is my firm belief, nothing is impossible for teacher.
Absolutely.
Teachers are the only people who can do the wonders, not the AI at all.
Very true.
Now, Madam Lily Roy was, she is looking also like a lily flower. So actually, this essay type correction is also there in the Google form. We are doing it. In our school, they are already started doing it. And the teachers are enjoying doing the essay type questions. Correction is being done by the Google form. There are limitations, but again, that creativity is required. What term should be there? How many words should be there? How many characters should be there? If you give that thing, they are doing it. And during my visit to Cambridge, we have done this experiment. We have given the essay type questions. Three teachers have corrected the copies, and using the Google form, not AI. Google form is a very simple thing. Using Google form, we have done that thing. And to our surprise, it was very closely matching. So means the teachers are not less than the Google form. Now come to the workload. See, workload will be more if the teacher is acting as a traditional teacher. If the teacher is acting as our teacher is becoming facilitator or the coach or the scaffolder, I don't find any workload. I don't find. Like, in administration also, if you put the system and processes in place, nothing. The strength of my school, single school, is 10,000 plus. Only one principal, one vice principal. We don't have HM also and supervisors. Things are going automatically just like a robot. I am sitting over here. All the 350 students of 12th standard along with the mother and father and came and signed and gone. And still I'm sitting here and taking the class. See, there is no workload. The workload is if you are traditionally behaving like that, then the workload is there, otherwise nothing. Achha, Google Forms and all, it was available from so many years. We were not using it. This pandemic, which is a boon for us, forced us to use it. And now we have become a master of using the Google Forms. Same with AI. But the thing is, we have to find out the ways how to use it. That if that is done, there is no load. There is no workload. This is the way. Another thing is, now come to the point of differentiation. See, what is the differentiation? How we are differentiating the students? which battery is 100% successful to differentiate the child, why we are branding them, and who are we to brand them? That's a big question. Yes, but differentiation is what? Give the academic ownership to the student, let them do the work at their own pace and speed. Nowadays, the future is for metacognitive skills. What is metacognitive skill? To learn about oneself. The student will know what will make that child happy, how it make it happy, what he wants to learn, when he wants to learn, when she, in what manners he wanted to learn. So these are all depending, and these are you know, individualized. So that is differentiation. A student wanted to learn something with using the audio visual, and we are using pen and paper and whiteboard and blackboard and PPT. Another one who wanted to learn the geometry while dancing, and we are saying, oh, strict discipline should be there. Third person is there who wanted to ask the question beyond, and we are saying, oh, don't be over smart. So that is the differentiation. And AI is very, very useful in differentiation, because AI provides them their own pace, their own speed, their own time, the way they wanted to do, when they wanted to do, what they wanted to do. See, in the examination nowadays, what we are testing, we are asking them to mug up and omit in the examination. More than that, if you allow them to use the internet and ask the question which is beyond, see the what the charm of the examination will be. See the way they will create. With these techniques, they have created Mangalyaan at the reasonable cost of auto rickshaw. And still we are going on that. And we are talking about the differentiation. There are students who don't want to write, but they are doing wonders. There are students who are failing in the 11th standard, but they only know why Apple is falling down, and they change the world. So what the differentiation is? Yes, AI provide them whenever they want to do. They will switch on the internet. They will find out something. They will work on that. They will customize it, and they will do it. That is required. And the National Education Policy 2020 is focusing on that. It's focusing on that. But the thing is, teacher who is the original and who can change the world, they have to come out of their comfort zone to be a step ahead. They have to utilize the AI. They have to use AI. They should not get used by AI. Again, it's my firm belief, if the teachers are using AI, they can do the wonder. But if they get used by AI, then things will disturb. See, what this PPT and what this projector and what the computer will do, what the computer is technologically, if you say in electronics, we used to say, computer is a buddhu baksa. Whatever we plan, computer will do that. Who will plan? The human brain. Who will train the human brain? The teacher. What way? Using AI. So if we use AI effectively, there is no question of differentiation. Those who wanted to understand the acute angle and the right angle and the obtuse angle by Kuchipudi dance, they will put on that video and they'll understand that thing. They'll very easily understand that thing. Those who wanted to understand the variety of fruits and all, they will put something, some other thing, and then they will find out which type of fruits are there, what is there, and they will understand it. But time is required. That much time we cannot give in the schooling. So then how will you provide that? Provide them the technological aspect, provide them that platform. And another thing is unnecessary, we are blaming. If there are the remote areas, in the remote areas, this is not offline. Many things are freely available. No need of going only online. Online going is becoming a status symbol nowadays. I am online. Otherwise, offline, everything is available. Take the case of that top 30. 30 students selected. Street beggar. Right. No book. No internet. Not even the blackboard. Whichever way the school donate in the books, those books become the resources. And all the 30 were selected in IIT, and they were in first 500. And those who are Wi-Fi, five-star school, air condition, this and that, and they are not seen in the first 1,000 and 2,000. Why? Where is the differentiation there? So the differentiation is within. branding is not good, but yes, we have what the problem is, we don't want to help them in under the name of differentiation. We say this is below average. What below average? Your thought process is below average. The child is never below average. The child is always equally good. You are not reaching to the level of the child. Either your system is not allowing you, or your devices are not allowing you, or you yourself is not allowing you to do that. So AI is the better way to provide them the platform to do the work at their own pace, at their own speed, at their own interest, at their own time, at their own mood. The problem of differentiation will not be raised. This differentiation, actually, what is happening? There are some parents, you know, always one parent came to me. My child is, you know, he is overreacting. Okay, why is over? So he is punching in the wall. Okay, why? What is your home environment? No, nice room we have provided, and we ensure that he should not make that room dirty. Okay, yeah. That child, when we see, I asked my art and craft teacher, sir, very good painter. I put her drawing in my room. Still, it is there in my room. Now, a child is a painter, used to throw the paints here and there, and you want that child to be disciplined. What will happen? Punch in the, and then we'll go to the psychologist and this and whatnot. Nothing will work. Satisfy the inherent talent of a child using AI, using technology, reaching to the level of the students, there is no differentiation. Yes. But the lesson plan should be in such a manner that you should reach to the last child of the class, as well as you should challenge to the first child of the class. Now, challenging the first child of the class and reaching to the last child of the class, whatever you have to use, you should use. And who will decide that? Your lesson plan, your style of teaching, your thought process. Sometimes your thought process is required. Let them take to the ground. That ground, going to the ground, become artificial intelligence. Sometimes let's dance with them. That's become artificial intelligence. Sometimes show them the video. That's become artificial intelligence. Sometimes take them to the computer lab and ask them if this internet is available, and now do whatever you wanted to do. Just like Professor Sugata Mitra has done. Do whatever you wanted to do. See what outcomes will come. Give them the chance. If we are not giving the chance, then what will happen? Then the question of differentiation. See, teaching and learning in one sentence, you make them busy. Otherwise, they will make you busy. Now, if you wanted to become busy, then your workload will be very, very huge. If you make them busy, then the things are solved. Now, for making them busy, technology, artificial intelligence, machine, your thought process, questioning skill, group discussion, seminars, challenging them, play Sudoku, play Antakshari. These are all techniques to make them busy. They make the learning enjoyable. And that is happening. And this pandemic is a boon for that. Let me tell you, my KG teachers, some of them are here. They were telling, sir, these small kids, you know, they wanted to go here and there. And then plan something, what to do, virtually plan something. So they plan a virtual tour. So in that virtual tour, they took them to the aquarium, to Burj Khalifa, and where not. So that's become a practice. So they utilize that thing, and then the most lovable class and most techno-savvy class become the KG class. We were thinking the KG students will not, you know, it will be very challenging. The 11th standard and 12th standard will do very well. They are doing very well, but side by side, they are doing so many other well activities also. So for them also, what we have done, see, teacher were teaching, they would start another screen and they started discussing. So I told them, okay, they wanted to discuss, make a Zoom break room, put them in one room and let them discuss whatever they want to discuss. So now they started discussing academics only. Otherwise, they were discussing something. WhatsApp was going on, this was going on, FB was going on. Because see, you are using technology and you are doing the moral policing. It will not work. Use the technology. Have a trust within them, give them complete freedom. Let them do that thing. So they were using the Zoom break rooms. In that break room, 10 students are there. Now, while putting those 10 students, find out whether you are putting the heterogeneous group or you are putting the similar type of students, then you decide that thing. Similar means not the IQ level, the thought process. If their thought process is same, okay, put them. If all are good at art and craft, put them in one room. All are good at dance, put them in another room. The differentiation happened. So this way, if we are utilizing AI, so everything is possible. Again, I am repeating, nothing is impossible for the teacher. The thing is, they have to come out of comfort zone of being traditional teachers. They should become a techno-savvy teacher. Future is there. And differentiation and whatnot, whatever be the buzzing terms you say, solution is there. Because in teaching learning process, nothing goes ahead without the problem. And every problem by default has the solution. The role of a teacher, the main differentiation is what? Find out that solution, reach to the root cause of that problem and resolve it and freeze it. So just identifying, freezing it, solution is there for the differentiation. Otherwise, unnecessary branding the child, he is gifted and talented and he is below, this is not going to happen. Because world has seen APJ Abdul Kalam was a below average student, changed the world. Aristotle changed the world. Newton failed in 11th standard, changed the world. Madame Curie, after marriage only, when the husband started shouting, she started discovering something. MC has discovered and changed the world. So the spark, you have to ignite that spark. Igniting the spark by your lesson plan, using the technology, is the true differentiation. So that is my input. I think I have lengthened my speech. That is my good habit or bad habit, I don't know. But
it's a very all good inputs, learned a lot, all good insights. And
thank you.
I think we as educators, we need to realize that we don't need to stop learning and keep on learning and take everything rather than, you know, being complacent and being in a comfort zone.
Yes.
Yes. Technology will not take us over. We need to take over technology.
Yes. Yes.
That way. Fantastic, sir. Fantastic. Fantastic, ma'am. It's been a wonderful session with all of you. We've really enjoyed and fantastic learnings from all the panelists over here. I should be really thanking Lily ma'am, Bhavna ma'am, Jyoti ma'am, and Pramod sir. Thank you very much for being on the panel. Thank you to all the participants. But before we leave, sir, we want a small message from all of you as panelists. Lily ma'am, to start with you, what would...
Yeah, before that message, because yes. All the participants have joined and they are interested, more interested in this e-certificate also. So,
yes, sir. That will
cite
also...
something. They can get the e-certificate, their name or something. How you are going to plan that thing, I don't know.
Sir, right now we do not have the e-certificates for the participants made because we do not know who would be joining. So we have taken attendance right now. The certificates would be given to them tomorrow. They'll be mailed to each of them tomorrow because you got everybody's mail IDs with us.
Yeah, you got their mail ID, no? Yeah.
Everybody's mail ID.
Great.
We'll be mailing the certificates to all of them tomorrow.
Yeah.
Right now, just for the closing, we want a small message from Lily ma'am first.
Yeah.
What is the message you would like to give us as a closing message, ma'am?
Sir, I would say about this AI, actually, I have done course from Coursera and all, but really speaking, I have learned last 2-3 days, I have learned, okay, more about, I have going through the internet, I have learned and all. So I will give message and about this online classes. Earlier, we were never knowing all this. We have learned a lot within this 4-5 months. And truly speaking, my daughter is an IT engineer. She is at home right now. I'm learning from her. So my message is that we should not have shy to learn from younger also. We should keep on learning. And sometimes I think one of the madam or sir told, we even learn from the student. So yes, for learning, there is no age. So we should keep on learning and upgrade ourselves. This is my message. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Lily ma'am. And I don't think Jyoti ma'am has not joined us with you, right? She's not come back?
Yeah, not yet. Not yet. So she had to visit.
Okay. Bhavna ma'am, a message, a closing message from you, ma'am. Bhavna, ma'am?
My message to all the educators and teachers, especially, that of course AI, as I had told you in my initial discussion, that that's the buzzword. We cannot rule out the role of AI in a teacher's life, but we need to remember for always that the role of the teacher can never be replaced. The empathy that the teacher would have, the involvement of the teacher, the passion of the teacher, or you say the change of method of teaching at a certain point of time, given the ability of the child, those are certain qualities in us as teachers, as educators, which cannot be replaced. They are very much of human in nature, and we need to remember that we need to upgrade ourselves, as Lily ma'am has said, and of course Pramod sir also, that we'll have to be updated. We have to be abreast with the growing technology, but the core of a teacher's heart would definitely be empathy and passion. So please keep up that spirit in you and go ahead with and take the world with a storm.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for such a wonderful...
All educators, teachers, and the panelists, and special thanks to Preeti and Prasad, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. And a message from you, Pramod sir. Your final closing.
My message is learning should not be quarantined. Because this is the age of pandemics, we have to use those those words. Learning should not be quarantined. It means learning should happen anywhere, everywhere, anytime, every time, with anybody and everybody.
Absolutely.
And for that, you have to do a lot. So what to do, how to do, when to do, keep on doing. Things will be ours. Future will be ours.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. And
thanks for inviting me. Thanks to Jyoti ma'am. Actually, Jyoti ma'am asked me, come, we'll do something. Yeah, definitely. Why not? So it's like that. And then she has connected me with Preeti ma'am. I troubled her a lot, asking so many questions. How you're going to this? Why you're going to this? And then I came to know that you are doing that thing. And then I remembered Mrs. Pooja Singha, your wife. She's a good friend of mine. Then, okay. Now good people are there. So let's work with them. And really, I enjoyed today's session.
Thank you, sir.
The thing is, the audience is a little bit somewhat passive. They should kept somewhat active.
Yes,
Prasad sir, you plan something like that. They should also, they should also rock. Not only the speakers.
We will do that, sir. We'll have a next time. We'll just have a interactive sessions.
Yeah.
You can ask questions, talk to us.
Yeah.
I think we should be able to answer them.
Yes.
Yeah. But before we just leave the platform, I want Preeti ma'am to give us the final conclusion and overview of the complete session. Yes, Preeti ma'am, the full thing is to you now.
Yes, sure. Thank you. I would say that artificial intelligence actually should be introduced from pre-primary itself. Because many a times what happens is when children see a robot moving with battery or a car moving, they think, अरे वाह ये कैसा चल रहा है, तो magic है, they get carried away. They should know all this is actually man-made. There is a human mind which is running behind this. So even they can do anything and everything. And for adults to know, wherever we travel, we just put on our GPS, global positioning system, but it is interchanged with GPS, I would say guru positioning system. It is the guru behind this, the mastermind behind this, who has made this, who GPS. So it is not the machine, but it is you as a human being, and like learn whenever and wherever possible. Thank you.
AI rather than should be introduced only from the KGI.
Yes, right.
Then only it will work out. If you are introducing for higher classes, it will not work out.
Absolutely.
Because it is an established fact. The learning happens in those years only. After that, only sharpening and polishing. So when the actual years are there, what we do, we kill those years.
Absolutely right.
Say, Roni, what is that? Yes, Papa, eating sugar. No, Papa. And then gaming is going on. And, a permanent damage we make. And then we keep on, doing something with experimenting. That should not be there, actually. No, everything, whatever has to be introduced from the, you know, that early ages. And that's why that ECCA, early child care education now in NEP, if in true sense it is implemented, really not the guru, but the India will be the Vishwaguru. But again, if we keep on doing that thing, Johnny, Johnny, yes, Papa, then the problem will be there. By the way, that's a very good rhyme and I love that rhyme. But, but the thing is, yeah.
Great, sir. Great, great. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, all the participants, for being with us. A wonderful response. And looking forward to associating with all of you in the near future, sir. Ma'am, thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Prasad, Preeti, Miss Lily.
Thank you, Lily, ma'am. Thank you, Bhavna, ma'am.
Yes. Thank you all, ma'am. The educators, teachers, and participants.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
And you know, audience, they are passive, but they are actually a rocking stars.
Absolutely.
Give them the chance, they will grill us. I know that thing very well.
Absolutely. That is why we are not giving them the chance.
Very true.
Yeah. It becomes difficult to answer them at times.
Yeah, and that is really the intelligence, you know. Otherwise, everything is artificial only. What now we are prepared and we are telling something. The reality is, if you get their questions and then you will get challenged. Right. Then you will ask yourself, are you a speaker?
Absolutely.
Definitely. We will do that next time. We will keep the platform open only to the participants.
Right. Every seminar I am telling that thing, I am getting the answer. Next time we will do that. Next time
we will surely do it.
Let's hope this square will do that.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thanks. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Can we end the meeting?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Good night, everyone.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye. Take care. Bye-bye.